Gravity gradient stabilization is a method of maintaining a spacecraft's orientation whilst it orbits, without using any propellant or power. Without any form of stabilization, objects appear to rotate in the opposite direction to that which they are orbiting. For example, a craft orbiting clockwise would rotate anti-clockwise. We see this happen in Kerbal Space Program, and it makes docking more difficult by constantly moving the docking port. The way around this is to approach perpendicular to the direction of movement along the axis of rotation. However, stabilization of some sort remains necessary in order to keep instrumentation on communications satellites pointed down towards the surface of the planet. Otherwise, they would rotate away and you'd only get signal for a few hours each day. So, how to stabilize? Well, you need to apply some sort of rotational force that's exactly equal and opposite to the rotation we observe here. You could do this with reaction control systems and use up your finite supply of propellant, or you could do this with some sort of reaction wheel and only use up electricity, or you could let orbital mechanics do it for you. To begin, you must first understand that the mass of an object does not exist solely in one point. The center of mass is merely the balance point of all the matter spread across the object. The spacecraft as one object follows one orbital trajectory because the mass is all physically connected together. If it wasn't all connected together, it wouldn't be one object. So, all of the spacecraft follows one trajectory because it is one object. It has one velocity that all parts of the object share. Keep that in mind. Next, some orbital mechanics. Objects in a lower altitude orbit have to travel faster than objects in a higher altitude orbit, as less velocity is required at higher altitudes to be in a circular orbit. However, it's perfectly possible for objects at different altitudes to have the same velocity. They just wouldn't follow a circular path that would be elliptical. A mass with more velocity than required to maintain circular orbit at its altitude would move out to a higher altitude before falling back down to where it originally was. At a higher altitude, it has less velocity than required to maintain circular orbit, which is why it falls back down. Momentum is conserved. I hope you're still with me, this is a little bit difficult to explain. Right, with that in mind, let's go back to our spacecraft with the mass spread out. Some of this mass is at a higher altitude than the other mass, but they all share the same velocity. Less velocity is required at a higher altitude to maintain orbit, and more is required at lower altitudes. Therefore, the mass at higher altitudes has more velocity than required to follow the orbit of the spacecraft, and will try to move out to an even higher altitude, applying force to the object. Similarly, the mass at lower altitudes has insufficient velocity to follow the orbit and will try to fall down to a lower one, applying force to the object. The combination of these forces causes the low altitude mass to stay low and the high altitude mass to stay high, keeping the spacecraft as a whole oriented one way. Of course, there are problems with this. Three major limitations on the effectiveness of gravity gradient stabilization are height, altitude, which in this context don't mean the same thing, and tensile strength of the entire spacecraft as a whole. If a spacecraft doesn't extend across a great enough distance, then the difference in altitude between our high and low masses becomes negligible, and the force of the masses trying to occupy different orbits becomes insufficient to stabilize the craft. As a result, objects making use of gravity gradient stabilization require components that extend a great distance. A perfect example of this would be space elevators, which extend past the altitude of geostationary orbit and remain perpendicular to the surface. Another example could be the suggestion for space-based solar power called Sun Tower, which consists of a tower of solar panels. For information on the topic of space-based solar power, click the annotation or link in the description. The limitation of altitude is related to the gravity gradient. The difference in velocity is required for orbit at different altitudes that results in stabilization, like we've just said. This difference decreases as altitude increases, making gravity gradient stabilization less effective the higher up you are, and making spacecraft at very high altitudes require extremely long components to counter this. Finally, the force exerted on the craft by it essentially trying to pull itself apart will succeed unless it has a high resistance to this, a high tensile strength. This is why space elevators haven't happened yet, as one of the few materials capable of dealing with the force created across such a long distance, carbon nanotubes, has yet to be manufactured in sufficient quantities. To summarize, Gravity gradient stabilization is a method of keeping spacecraft oriented in one direction through the extension of craft across sufficiently large range of altitudes. It's effective because it requires no propellant or power to maintain, but is only practical at lower altitude orbits. Before finishing the video, I just want to mention that there's one reason Kerbal Space Program doesn't do this, and that's because it treats individual vessels as a single mass. If it didn't do this, the calculations required to apply the correct forces to every part would make the game even harder to run on low-end machines, and impossible to build large space stations in. Hence why vessels flip head over heels as they orbit. For more explorations into space-based scientific principles and into the game Kerbal Space Program, take a look at the description of this video or my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.